Good morning everyone, how's it going today? Welcome back to the channel. In today's video, I just bring you some very quick use cases of Nano Banana in a notebook that you see right here. So we're going to be taking a look at how to update a picture by keeping the same person, just having her wear something different and be somewhere else. We're going to take a look at how to change their clothes with very tiny details but keep the image the same. We're going to see how to generate images from scratch, generate characters, generate e-commerce photos, generate logos, etc. So let's take a look at all of these examples. We're going to be using Nano Banana or Gemini Flash Image Generation, which is the latest image generation model by Google. And we're going to be showing you everything right here from the notebook. Of course, the notebook is available in the description if you want to take a look at it. So there you go. Let's go. All right, so the first thing that you're going to want to do right here is you're going to want to come right here to aistudio.google.com, and right here you're going to be prompted to create your own account. And once you're there, what you're going to want to do, you're going to go to dashboard, you're going to go right here to API keys, and you're going to hit on create a new API key. Now, what's something that you may have to do before is you may have to create an account right here on console.cloud.google.com. And from here, you create an account, then you're going to want to create a new project. So you're going to click right here, you're going to click on new project right here, you're going to name it whatever you want to name it, and then you will be able to create an API key for that project, okay? And the way to do this is you're just going to look up an API for a project, and right here you're going to select the project that you have created. And then you're going to look up the API for that project, and here you will have your API, and you're just going to copy it. Okay. So now that you have your API key, we can actually start developing and building our notebook right here in Colab. So let's get right into that. All right. So the first thing that we're going to want to do is we're going to want to install the dependencies that we need to actually call our model. And in order to do this, you're going to have to install this package right here, Google GenAI. And this is the package that is going to give us access to the SDK, which will allow us to call the model that we want to call right now. After that, we're going to have to initialize our API key. And in order to do that, I'm just going to run this thing right here. And right here, I'm going to paste the API key that I just got from my dashboard, just like that. And then once that is done, I am going to be able to initialize my client, which is the one that I'm going to be able to use to run my this model. So I'm going to do from Google import GenAI and client equals GenAI.client. And this one is going to take only one parameter, which is going to be the API key that I just got from the dashboard. So I'm just going to execute this, and it's going to initialize my session with Google. And then after that, I'm going to be able to actually start taking a look at all of the use cases that this model has for us. So let's take a look at some of those use cases. All right, so the first thing that I want to show you is that I have this very quick helper function that just displays the before and the after of any image that I'm passing through this model. So this is just a very quick function that takes the before image and then the response from the model and displays the image one side by side. And basically what I'm doing is I'm just going into the response object right here and getting the actual image right here. And that's all that's going on right here. Okay. So just so you don't get lost when I call this. And here I have my prompt that I'm going to be using actually. So just for the record, what I'm going to be doing is I'm going to be taking a stock image of this woman right here. And we're going to be changing pretty much everything of the image. We're going to be changing where she is located, what she's wearing, what she's holding in her hands. Maybe her hat as well. We're going to change a bunch of things. But ideally, we want her to remain the same person, which is a little bit of a tricky thing with these models. But Nano Banana actually seems to be doing a pretty good job doing this. So let's take a look at how this works. So I'm going to take this image. I have actually previously uploaded all of these stock images right here to my notebook in Colab. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to just use this prompt right here. And I said, create an image of the woman in this picture with the following changes. And I said, she's wearing a white one-piece swimsuit. She's holding a smoothie in her hands. She's at the beach with the ocean behind her. She's sitting on a towel on the sand. And she is wearing a white Panama hat. And let's take a look at what this looks like. First of all, we're going to just open the image that I have uploaded, which is this stock image number one. And then we're just going to call our model using this method right here. We're going to do client.models.generateContent. Be sure to select this model right here, which is the latest model for image generation at Gemini, of course. So this is the Nano Banana model. So Gemini 2.5 Flash Image Preview. And right here, you're going to send the contents as well. Now, very interestingly, the contents are basically everything that you're going to be sending to the model. There is no separate field for images or text. Everything goes right here. So the image, you're going to pass it right here just as you opened it, and the prompt also right here in the same list. And then basically that will return to you the image. So I'm just going to execute it. And remember that this helper function will just display the before and the after of this image. So let's wait a few seconds and see what it ping. Oh, there you go. And there we have it. So this is the original image that I showed you before, and this is the other image that was generated. This seems to be the same person to me. So yeah, I mean, it's always hard to tell when you don't really know the person, but this definitely looks like the same person. So there you go. And this would be just a very quick example of how to change a photo. Feel free to test it with your own photos. Of course, do not test this with any photo of anyone from whom you don't have consent to upload this right here. But yeah, feel free to try this out. Let's go to the next use case right here. All right, so the next thing that I wanted to show you is this other kind of a possibility that you can do. Like in this example, we basically changed the entire image, right? But it is also very useful, this model, to change specific things in the image and leave the image pretty much unchanged, just changing very few things. And in this case, that's what we're going to do. We're going to change the color of this woman's coat. We're going to make it be light green. And we're also going to change her hat. So instead of having this nice, beautiful hat, we're going to have her hat wear a top hat instead. So let's just take a look at how this works. Very straightforward, same thing. I'm just sending the whole thing, the prompt and the before image right here into the client. And then I'm just going to be displaying the before and after right here. And there you go. So basically it is the same image, but with a few changes. This can be extremely useful if you're just doing some editing or if you're just, if you just want to change something in your own photos. Very, very nice. Yeah, just looks supernatural. Love it. All right, so in this example right here, we're going to generate a tile of cartoon style stickers that can be either stickers or, I mean, you can also use this technique to probably generate the characters for your video game or something like that. But the idea right here is that it will generate multiple positions of the same character performing different actions. So as you can see here, I am asking it to generate a grid or images of a penguin holding an ice cream cone and performing different activities. And here we have it. So he's skating, like they're going to the pool, a bunch of different things. So as you can see, very, very reliably the same character and perform different actions. Very, very useful thing that you can do right here. Right, so next thing to keep in mind is this other possibility that you can do. So far I have shown you how to update an image that already exists, but you can also generate an image completely from scratch using this model. And in order to do that, what Google recommends is that you explain in a very clear detail exactly what you want to see in the image. And actually that kind of turns out to be rather repeatable. What's going to happen right here is that here I'm just sending a prompt saying that you have to generate a photorealistic close-up portrait of an elderly Japanese ceramicist with deep sun-edged wrinkles and a warm, knowing smile. He is carefully inspecting a freshly glazed tea bowl, etc. So, I mean, it's a very long and very clear prompt of exactly what you want. And something very interesting is that I have actually run this prompt, which is, by the way, this is the prompt that comes in the official demo from Google, and it gives out this. So I'm going to run it again to show you what this looks like. So contents. Oh yeah, I forgot to send in the prompt right here. The prompt is this one right here. So I'm going to show you what this looks like. And you will see how it's rather this, it's relatively the same image that was generated before. So yeah, I mean, in this case, it's just a bearded man. But as you can see, it's almost the same, which really is interesting because it means that you can have pretty reproducible or repeatable results using similar prompts. So very interesting thing to delve more into. So yeah, just be sure to describe your image in a very clear way in order to have a better result. And an advice, a piece of advice that they say, that they give you right here at Google, right there at Google, is that you should not describe the entire thing as a just like a bunch of keywords like you would usually do in, with models such as Midjourney or Stable Diffusion, for example, where you usually just send a bunch of different keywords of exactly what you want. So realistic, super realistic, comic or something like that. And in this case, what they want you to do is to describe the entire scene. So as you can see right here, this is not just a bunch of keywords. This is an actual description of the scene. So just keep that in mind when you're generating images with this model right here. Let's take a look at the next use case. And another thing that I wanted to show you how to do is this thing that you see right here. So basically, you take a photo of any object. So I basically just sent it over my watch in just an any position you want. I mean, it doesn't have to be a particular position, and you turn it into a ready-to-ship picture for an e-commerce website. A very useful thing, probably, if you have an e-commerce website or if you want to create an e-commerce picture generator or something like that, very useful. So the prompt goes like this. Given the input image, generate a high-resolution studio photograph of the object. The image should have a professional studio lighting with some shadows, sharp focus and highlight product details, etc. There you go. I mean, of course, feel free to upload your own image right here. So in my case, I uploaded the image of this watch. As you can see, this is what I got. And same thing with my mocha. So basically, I just sent in my mocha pot, and it returned a very nice picture of a mocha that I can just put into my e-commerce website. So there you go. Now, this can also be very useful to generate logos. I mean, it's probably not the best at that, but it can do it, and it's pretty accurate with text, which is something quite impressive. So here I asked it to create a sleek minimalist logo for a tech startup called AstroMind. The text should be in modern geometric sans-serif font, include a simple abstract icon of a planet with rings. The color scheme of is white and blue on a black background. So not a great designer, as you can tell. But there you go. We can just execute it and see what it returns to us. It's going to be very straightforward, and let's just see how it goes. So AstroMind, nice little planet right there. And actually, what I'm going to do is I'm going to now take this logo and put it on top of the image of this lady right here, which is this one right here. So we're going to take the image of this lady, and we're going to take the t-shirt, and we're going to place the logo on top of the t-shirt. So let's take a look at how that would work. Same thing, I'm going to send a prompt saying, take the first image of a woman with a brown hair, brown eyes and a smile, something that Google actually recommends that you do when you're trying to modify or update an image, just very slightly, but you want the rest to remain the same, to describe actually very accurately what is initially at the photo or at the picture. So in this case, we're describing that she has brown hair, brown eyes, and a smile, and add the logo from the second image onto her black t-shirt. Position the logo on the chest on the left side of her t-shirt. Ensure the woman's face and features remain completely unchanged. The logo should look like if it's naturally printed in the fabric, following the folds of the shirt. So here, as you can see, I am getting the stock image of the woman, and then I am passing the logo image alongside my prompt. So I'm passing three different things: my prompt, the before image, which is the woman, and the logo image, which I basically just downloaded and saved right here. So I'm just going to execute this. This was with the other test that I made. So let's take a look at what this actually gives us. Hopefully it is going to mix the image and logo correctly. Let's take a look. And there we go. So we have the before of the woman that I showed you. And right here, we have the other image right here of her with the logo now on her t-shirt in just a few seconds, really. So very, very powerful, very useful. All right, now last but not least, what we're going to do is we're going to take an image of this model right here. And let's suppose that you have an e-commerce store and then you have this dress that you want to sell, but you want to have the dress to showcase the dress in like someone wearing them. And so what we're going to do is we're going to take this woman and we're going to have her wear this dress right here. So same thing, remember to describe your images very accurately so that they do not get updated or modified by the model. So what we're going to do is we're going to say create a professional e-commerce fashion photo. Take the blue dress with white spots from the first image and let the woman from the second image wear it. Generate a realistic full body shot of the woman wearing the dress with the lighting and shadows adjusted to match the outdoor environment. And then we're just going to execute it. And there we go. So we have the image of the before image with the lady right there. And then we have the image of her wearing the dress that we just wanted her to wear. And there you go.